Hello everybody, welcome back. And in contrast to the previous videos, in this video we're not going to focus on a chart, but we're going to focus on a table. What we see over here is a full profit and loss statement. And when you see it, you think, well, that's easy, that's just we created an Excel, copy, paste, done. But we designed our dashboard with a grid. And I can promise you that grid is not going to match with the column layout of this table. And nevertheless, we want to have it in. And now you see the grid lines behind the table and you see what kind of mess it is. So we have to find a solution for that. And that solution I'm going to show you in Excel. So here we have our table. If you have a look at the file yourself, you can see how we get all that information in with the sumifs. But what we want to do is we want to copy that data into our dashboard. And that's how we start. So I will select everything that I need. Control C, and it is copied. And I go to my dashboard. I position the cursor on the right place. In this cell, there I want to have it. And I'm going to paste it. But you can imagine if I paste it, let's do it, then we can see it. If I paste it, it's going to be one ugly mess. So we don't want to do that. So we do Ctrl Z to undo this. I'm going to select the cell. And instead of pasting, I'm now going to say I want to paste it as a linked picture. And that's a very nice feature. In previous versions of Excel, it was hidden very deep away. It was called the camera tool. But now it's on our paste special menu, and it's this option, the linked picture. And what's very nice about this is, here it is. It behaves as a picture. So if we want, we could rotate it. But it's still linked to the data. So if I change something in the data, let's do that, because I don't like the black negative numbers. These should be red. So we're going to change that. So we're over here. I'm going to select all the numeric values. Control 1 gives us the shortcut to the cell properties, and now I'm going to say I want to have it like this, but now the numbers are too big, so we have to adjust that a little bit by saying that we want to have them in thousands, and the red after the semicolon is telling us that if the value is negative, it should be red. So if I do it like that, and if I go back to my dashboard, it should be refracted in my funny rotated P&L. And there it is. So let's see if we can get it straight again. There it is. And we have to adjust the format a little bit. And here I use the Alt button again to make sure it will move with the grid. And then I will cheat a little bit to do it so. And there we have our data. And it's linked, so if any of the figures changes, the table will also change. And what we should do is get rid of some of the mockup titles. So we will remove this chart title, the chart footer, chart title, chart footer, and area title, and area title. And the rest we will clean up later on. But here we have our table. So that was something different, not a chart, but a table. Let's see what the next video is going to be. There we're going to work with something you also saw in one of the earlier lectures, that are the sparklines. See you then.